So I'm Ragnhild Nilsen, living in the southern coast of Norway in Kristiansand. And that means that we have a lot of sea around us. And Norway is famous for its salmon and its oil and its gas. That has made us a very rich country. And we are happy in the way that a lot of the egalitarian touch which we have in our country makes this money for all. But when you look at the fishing industry, it isn't the same. And what I now experience here on the coastline is that a lot of very rich people, they want to have more, especially when it comes to the salmon industry. And part of the south coast here is protected. The wildlife should be there, the birds, and of course, the wild salmon. And now in the backyard, and suddenly during the summertime, we see that these people who want to build out an industry where they want to grow or farm salmon is suddenly coming up. And what we have seen from other places in Norway where this is going on, and it was a surprise for me this summer when I understood it, is that there comes louse or lice on this salmon and full of pesticides. And the fish is also so stressed that actually a lot of it dies. And as a climate psychologist, if I think of the welfare of the fish, I get a very, not angry, but I sense the stress that the fish has. And I'm wondering, why should I, as a one person, allow this in the backyard of a protected area, which is one of the most, the nicest area we have in Norway? So I aligned with a lot of young people, older people, even dogs and cats. And we went to the authorities here in Kristiansand and we said, this is not okay, what is going on. We want to be part of it. We want to cooperate with you, but it must be transparent and we must know how you are going to farm this fish without destroying the wild fish, and if that is possible. And then I came up on a little idea which is growing in me nowadays, is that since I've been working with the textile industry for many years and innovated the first textile hand towel of seaweed. Seaweed is also something that you can grow. And maybe we can find ways to grow seaweed where this farmed salmon can grow in a natural way so that you don't fill it with food that is destroying the whole area into a desert, but that the seaweed itself will make both farming and the wild fish happy. So as a climate psychologist, I was thinking, at least I will go to the mayor and the authorities and tell them what I think we can do.
Ha ha.